Good afternoon, students. Welcome to another English class. In this class, I am going to take short compositions under writing skills. These short compositions comes under question number 3, section B. So today I am going to discuss these short compositions, especially the short compositions notice writing, poster preparation, advertisement, and process writing. Today we are going to discuss. So let us proceed. So short compositions you have for 4 marks. It comes under section B. Question number 3, notice writing, poster preparation, advertisement, process writing. These are all for 4 marks. In question paper, you will get 2 questions out of these 4 questions, and you have to attempt only 1 question, and it carries 4 marks. Now let us take first topic, notice writing. As you have learned notice writing, all these short compositions in class 11, I am just going to revise these topics. I am not going to teach anything new. So just let me go quickly. So notice writing, how to write the notice writing? Step 1, place an address from where the notice is being issued. So you have to write the name of the address from where, like if you are preparing the notice from your school as a school captain, then the address will be your school name. Step 2, mention the date on which the notice is written or sent. Date you have to write. Date the format is day, month and year format you have to follow. And step 3 is, it is preferable to write the heading of the notice. You have to write what is the topic of the notice, heading and topic. Then step 4, it must contain, that means the body of the notice must contain the time of the event, date of the event, place of the event and any other relevant information. And at the bottom, mention the name of the person who is issuing the notice on the left hand side, and the designation also, if you are writing as a school captain, you have to write, or a sports captain, you have to mention the designation also. Then while writing the body of the letter, you have to use formal language or appropriate language. And the word limit is 50 words, and the marks distribution for notice writing, not only for notice writing, for all other short compositions, poster preparation and advertisement and process writing, heading 1 mark, content 2 marks and expression 1 mark. Let us go to the next slide. So this is the format of notice writing. You have to write in this format. Heading comes at the top, and then notice, the word notice you have to write, and topic, whichever topic is asked to you in the question, you have to write that topic under this topic. And date, and this is the format, day, month and year format. And body of the notice you have to write within 50 words. But how to write the body of the notice? It should be in American format. That means wherever you have started writing the date, the letter D, exactly below that day you have to start writing the body of the notice, but leaving one line gap. And after completion of the body of the notice, you have to leave one more line gap, and then you have to write by and the name of the issuing authority and the designation of the issuing authority. Now this is a sample question for you. You are sports captain of KB Hebbal Bangalore. Write a notice in not more than 50 words for the school notice board, informing the students about the inter-school basketball match to be played between your school and KB Malleshwaram. So give all necessary details. I have prepared this small notice for you all for your reference. Go through this notice. Heading I have given Kendriya Vidyalaya Hebbal, notice, inter-school basketball match, date, today's, the date you are writing the notice, it should be mentioned, so today's date I have written. So the body of the notice is very simple, all the students of the school are hereby informed that an inter-school basketball match will be played between our school and KV Malleshwaram. The details of the same are given below. Date 26/4/2020, time 9 a.m. onwards, venue KV Hebbal school ground. That means you have to write the details of the event in a separate way. In this way you have to write, dividing the information into small chunks. So maximum gathering is desired by, write the name of the school captain and the designation is school captain. Now here is one more question for you practice. After completion of watching this video, you come back and you take down this question, or I will give you this question in the description box below or in the Google Classroom. Now let us proceed to the next short composition, poster preparation. It must be colorful, attractive and tempting. The difference between notice and poster is generally we give for uneducated people also, so that they can understand the information. So the main features of poster are layout, contents and expression. So another, how to write the layout, you should write title. It should be suggestive and catchy title. Use slogans, jingle or short verse. Sketch simple drawings, letters of different size and shape. It should be attractive. Then content, the theme or subject of the poster, details like time, date, venue, etc. and name of the issuing authority or organization. It should be written less and it should be shown more. So you have to draw pictures more in the content part. Then expression, use phrases, slogans, persuasive language, creativity in terms of content and design, overall organization and sequencing of the matter, and everything should be completed within 50 words. So here is an example for you. Design a poster in not more than 50 words for your school library and the value of books and good reading habits. You may use slogans, do not exceed 50 word limit. So here is an example poster I have prepared for your reference. Go through this. I have inserted only one picture here, but when you are preparing posters, you can insert many pictures, as many pictures as possible, so that it look most very attractive. But one suggestion, if you get notice and poster in examination, better you attempt notice writing, because it is less time consuming and you can write more effectively. Or if you are from biology background, if you can draw diagrams and pictures well, then it is up to you. You can go even with poster preparation. Now let us move to the next one. Here is exercise for you. The Directorate of Education Assam is organizing an essay contest for all the students of the state. Prepare a suitable poster which can be sent to different schools for display on their notice board. So this is for your exercise. Now we'll go to the advertisements. There are two kinds of advertisements, classifieds and commercials. Now there are we are going to take only classifieds. So under classifieds, we have five different kinds of advertisements are there: situation vacant, situation wanted, too late, lost, found, lost and found, and matrimonial advertisements. So the format is simple. You have to write the title, whether it is situation vacant or situation wanted or too late or sale, what kind of advertisement you are writing. You have to write the title, and the body of the advertisement must be within 50 words. Then how to write a situation vacant? I am going to just explain only one advertisement, otherwise it will be time consuming. So I am just going to explain situation vacant. Step 1, post to which a candidate is applying are required: qualification, experience, age, date of birth and sex, I mean gender. Then salary offered and pegs promised, mailing address and contact number, interview schedule, begin with wanted or required, mode of applying, any other relevant and important information. But let me ask one simple question: who issues situation vacant advertisement? Is it issued by employee or employer? Give me answer quickly. Now here is one example question. KVIOC Nunmati is looking for a receptionist for the school. Draft an advertisement in not more than 50 words to be published in classified columns of Hindustan Times. You are the principal of the school. Now here is a small advertisement issued by the principal of the school. Situation vacant is the title. Applications are invited for the post of receptionist for our school with fluency in English. Candidates of either sex between the age group of 28 and 35 years having a pleasant personality may only apply. Postgraduate in English with a diploma in journalism will be preferred. Pay, allowance and other perks negotiable. Apply to the principal of the KVIOC Nunmati within 3 days of this advertisement. So here is the detailed situation vacant advertisement. We will quickly go through other advertisements. You can check all these advertisements after completion of watching this video. I am going to give the link for this PPT also in the description box below. Now we will go to the process writing. What is process writing? Process writing is a way of breaking down the task of writing into its smaller component parts. So whenever somebody asks you to explain the process of preparing a tea or a coffee, then you should break the information into small pieces and steps so that it is easy for others to understand. So in examination point of view, you have to write a suitable and relevant title. Process, all stages should be described logically and systematically to get a complete coherence about the topic. So the format of the process writing is very simple. You have to write the title on the top, and then the steps or the process should be written in step wise. Let me show you that. So let me first give you a question. Sheetal's younger sister Seema is leaving for the boarding school. She wants to know the method of preparing tea. Sheetal decides to explain the process to her. Write the process description in not more than 50 words. So here we go with the preparation of Japanese tea. First you have to write the ingredients, serial number, item, quantity. It must be written in this tabular form so that it could be a little more attractive compared to other answers in the examination. And here left side you have to write the procedure. Here I have written the procedure in this way. Step 1, first put 1 tablespoon of green tea leaves in a ceramic cup. Step 2, take a bowl with some water and heat it. Let the water boil for a few minutes. Step 3, after that put a lid on the bowl and let the water sit for 2 or 3 minutes. Step 4, then pour water into the cup and put a lid on the cup and wait for 2 or 3 minutes. Step 5, later filter it so that the tea leaves are separated from tea. Step 6, finally the Japanese tea is ready. First look at the green tea, next smell its rich aroma and then sip it. Conclusion, we need to follow the above mentioned procedure in order to prepare Japanese tea. It can be written even in a single paragraph also, but don't you think that this looks very attractive? Today we have completed about short compositions. I have completed 4 short compositions, in fact, notice writing, poster preparation, advertisements and process writing.